In this video, we talk about monitors and how they work. We'll see how they can display a picture, how computer controls them, which are the most used technologies, and which are the main characteristics and specifications for gaming. First, primary colors. Every color is made from a mix of three primary colors, red, green and blue, and if we also modulate the brightness of the color, we get different shades of color. Dividing a picture in little square called pixel, and dividing each pixel in three subpixels, we can control the color of each pixel by modulating the brightness of each subpixel. So, looking at a screen with a magnifying glass, this is what we see. Millions of subpixels, red, green and blue. For example, in order to obtain the color yellow, we have to switch the blue subpixel off, leaving on the red and the green. In this way, at a certain distance, the whole pixel appears as yellow. So, by controlling each subpixel, we can show whatever picture. In order to memorize a picture, we can assign for every color a byte. So, we can memorize a pixel by storing 3 bytes. A byte can have 256 different combinations, so we can control 256 different shades of color. So, the computer memorizes pictures by storing 3 bytes for every pixel. And in order to control the screen, the computer creates a map of the screen, where each byte is related to the corresponding subpixel. So, computer has a representation of the screen in byte. By changing bytes, computer changes the image on the screen. Of course, by changing the byte map enough fast, computer creates the motion. This changing has to be at least of 24-30 frames per second. So now the problem is how to pass from the bytes to the color and brightness of the subpixel. There are different kinds of screen technologies. The LCD or liquid crystal display use a backlight as source of light and use liquid crystal to control the light beam. Let's see how to control a single pixel. So, we have a backlight which can be blocked from the LCD panel and a RGB filter. If the light passes through the filter, it results colored. We have in the LCD a grid of electrodes. For controlling the beam of light, the LCD can let pass through it. So, by means of an appropriate circuit, we apply an electric field which modifies the LCD molecule orientations in such a way they allow the beam of light to pass. The electric field strength is proportional to the beam of light passing, so to the brightness of the pixel. The strength of the electric field is controlled by the byte representing our pixel. In this case, for example, with the green subpixel at zero, we block the beam of light for the green filter, thus resulting in black. The final effect in the pixel is the magenta color. Applying this to all the pixels of the screen, we control the whole display. There are different kinds of LCD which differ from the way they let pass the beam of light. Here is the Twisted Nematic. TN panels contain liquid crystal positioned between two polarizing filters. Each filter is the same size but oriented at 90 degrees angles to each other, with one placed vertically and the other horizontally. In its default form, the light can pass through the filters because the molecules are twisted of 90 degrees, allowing light to pass through the filters. When voltage is applied to the liquid crystal, their molecules untwist, blocking light to pass through the filters. This system is applied to each pixel, which is divided into red, green and blue subpixels. The color of each subpixel is regulated by the voltage passing through. with each one having up to 256 shades available. The other well-known LCD technology is the IPS or in-plane switching. On the right, we can see how the molecules align parallel to the electric field, allowing the light to pass. When no electric field is applied, the molecules block the beam of light. On the left, there is the TN panel, where you can see that sunlight can pass despite the untwisted molecules. So the blacks aren't so dark in comparison at IPS panel. Another disadvantage of the TN panel is the terrible viewing angle. The advantage was the short time in which the molecules twist in respect to the alignment of the IPS. But modern IPS panel greatly improved this issue. The last technology is the OLED or organic light emitting diode. In the OLED, when an electric field is applied, the cathode gives electrons to the emissive layer, which become negative, and the anode takes electrons from the conductive layer, which becomes full of holes, which are free to move in a conductive material and are attracted from the electrons in the emissive layer. Recombining, they emit radiation in the visible spectrum. In this case, we don't have the backlight, so the blacks are deep and dark, and the power consumption is less than LCD displays. We have also better color and brightness. Don't get confused between an OLED TV and a LED TV. LED TV has LEDs as backlight, but it is an LCD technology. OLED TV has not backlight, and thus an OLED panel. Now let's see the most interesting specification of a monitor. Those you should check before to buy it. First, there is resolution. Resolution is the number of pixels you have in your display. For example, Full HD has 1920x1080, but resolution has to be compared to screen width. For example, Full HD can be okay for monitor of 24 inches or 32 inches, but maybe not for 75 inches. The important is the PPI or pixel per inch, so how many pixels there are in an inch. This is a density measure, the higher the better. But if you buy a monitor for gaming, maybe you don't need a high resolution because the screen is not so big, and because high resolution implies more RAM and more power on the graphic card to face higher loads, and this can lower the frame per second of your graphic card. One important feature is the refresh rate. It can be 60 Hz, 144, 240 or even higher. The refresh rate of a display is the number of times per second that the image refreshes on the screen. For example, a 60 Hz display will update the screen 60 times per second. Refresh rate has to be compared with FPS or frame per second. If we have monitor with refresh rate of 60 Hz and graphic unit which can send 120 frames per second, the monitor will refresh at half speed, and it will discard one picture every two. So something is lost in fluidity. It's lost for gamer is not good because you lose the opportunity to see something a fraction of a second before. So refresh rate has to be as higher as possible. And this means also your GPU can work very fast, but if the monitor has a low refresh rate, you are not seeing it. You are not exploiting the power of your GPU. In the opposite case, when GPU gives 60 FPS and refresh rate is 120 Hz, the monitor has to take twice the same picture. In this case, the bottleneck is the GPU. But in the real case, the GPU works at different FPS, and for the monitor can be difficult the synchronization. So a problem can appear. When the monitor is refreshing a picture, GPU sends another picture and the monitor continues the refreshing but using the new data, so the screen shows part of the old picture and part of the new one. This problem is called tearing and is quite annoying. The solution is a synchronization with the lower value between monitor and CPU. In our case, the working FPS and refresh rate become this. This can be achieved with the FreeSync or G-Sync technology. It depends on your GPU brand, NVIDIA or AMD. So the best thing to do against the tearing is buying an high refresh rate monitor with a sync feature and activate it. In any case, if for some reason the sync isn't helping in a specific game, you can deactivate it whenever you want. Another important specs for gamer is the input lag. This is the time you have to wait between your input, for example your moving of the mouse, and the appearance of the response in the monitor. You can understand this is very important for gamers. Be careful not getting confused with the monitor response time, which is largely advertised by manufacturers. Response time is the time the pixel takes to change color. Of course, the lower is the better, but if you are a gamer, you are more interested in input lag. Please leave me a comment and let me know if you liked this video. Make sure you put a thumb up, click the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel.